Finally, we come to the second example. Second example is based on practical tests. So we have two tanks. It's a little bit contraintuitive. Both of these tanks are pre-charged, and because the pressure in this tank is higher than in this tank, we basically get a flow that goes like that. And at a certain point of time, this valve here is suddenly closed. Yeah, so the liquid flowing like this basically sees a dead end all of a sudden, and that leads to a shock wave which travels through the system. Yeah, at t equal to 0.1 second, the valve is closed and we see that shock wave, and our liquid is loaded with a certain amount of undissolved gas. And other than this here, which we believe the author did not entirely measure correctly, perhaps all other parameters match exactly the ones that were measured. Here we see our simulation system, our DSH Plus model. So this green block is just there for the visualization to generate all of these plots that you saw earlier. And at the two different parameter sets were tested. So we have a flow rate to the reservoir of 0.3 meter per second and 1.4 meter per second. And let's check what results we have, and also compare them to the author's experiments. So this is the pressure in the pipeline. And here you see the pressure, the recorded pressures at different positions along the valve, along the pipeline, sorry. So what you see here, we are at 0.05 seconds. Soon the valve will be closed, and we see a sharp increase in the pressure. And now the pressure wave travels backwards, is reflected at the open end, and travels back to the closed end, where it again is reflected, but in a different way, since that is a closed end. And this creates a suction wave with cavitation. And on these diagrams, you basically see in blue, these recorded values. In blue, you see the actual measurement that was provided by Mr. Bergon. And in red, you see the simulation result with DSH Plus. And you can see that this very complex wave system, which is generated because these pressure waves are reflected, and they are also interacting with the cavitation. So the cavitation creates further reflections. You can see that these match very well. And I've seen a lot of CFD simulations of such problems. And believe me, these small differences that are still there, they can't get rid of them as well. So, but they take like 100 times as much time as our model. So you get the qualitatively, also quantitatively same results, but with much less calculation time. And what we see here are these really big spikes, which you would not really expect based on simple water hammer theory. So they are because of cavitation, because there are two effects that are superimposed. And as you can see, our software actually catches them perfectly. Here are, because you can go through these slides later on after the presentation, there is a theoretical explanation to how these additional contra-intuitive spikes happen, and how we take them into account. Here we see a different representation of what we have just seen as a video. So this is the time. So we march in time like that, and this is the length of our pipes. So you see here these waves that are formed. They travel. These shock fronts travel. They are reflected. They travel back and forth, and here we see basically how these two waves collapse. How these two waves are superimposed. So we see the cavitation, the collapse of the cavitation bubble, which generated a wave, and the reflected reservoir wave. How they sum up to form an even bigger wave, and they are way bigger than what you would expect based on simple theoretical analysis. Yeah, so this underlines how important it is to simulate such systems, because if you would give this to if you would give this as a kind of exam question, please calculate the maximum pressure that would occur, everybody with a hand calculation would underestimate it and would not arrive at this high pressure here. So we have done a different a second experiment also with 1.4 meters per second, and there you can see the first parameter set was 0.3. Now we do the one with 1.4. Now you see that even for this one we have a very good agreement with the measured values. Yeah, so you see the histories that were recorded by the experiment, and here you see how well our simulation software catches all of the relevant features, and even the timings, yeah, which are like a good indicator of how well your simulation captured the propagation of the propagation speed of waves. All of these match the actual results very closely. Yeah, so this is like you can really look inside the pipe. What is happening there? Where is the where is the vapor bubble formated? All of these can be analyzed, and for your sizing calculations, you get all the relevant pressures. Here you again see how well they are agreeing. Yeah, here I think we are running out of time. Here you can basically see again these spatial and temporal distributions at the same time, where you can follow the path of the waves. And you can clearly identify here in this plot where you see not the pressure but the vapor fraction, how the vapor bubbles are generated and collapse. Yeah. So that was it basically. We are coming to the summary now. What you should take home is that we have three types of cavitation. We have the actual vapor cavitation, or cavitation in the strict sense, where you have pressures below vapor pressure. We have the gas cavitation, where you have bubbles because of the decreased gas solubility of liquids at low pressures. And we have the pseudocavitation, where already existing bubbles just change their volume because of different pressures. And generally, the cavitation is undesired because it limits the flow rate through resistors, valves, and similar devices. It causes noise, vibration, and damages to your system. And you should take these effects into account at a very early stage of system design. And one way to do that is the simulation. And as you have seen by the comparison between experiment and a simulation, these effects can be easily taken into account by using a sophisticated 1D simulation software such as our DSH Plus.